أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ما بعد. I think there was enough time for you to drink tea and coffee before the class. I will give myself exception. خلاص؟ Or خلاص. Also I'll leave it after the class. يلا. To respect the class. طيب. Because I need to go to work after the class. If you have night duty, you drink tea or coffee. If you go, you are going home, خلاص. No tea and coffee. To sleep. Peaceful, inshallah. طيب. طيب. Let's continue the chapter of Psalm. We reach to the point of Dalil al-Talib. Our book is called Dalil al-Talib. What does it mean, Dalil al-Talib? The guide of the student. Dalil means guide. Talib, student. Huh? So Dalil al-Talib. About fiqh. The author is called Mar'i ibn Yusuf al-Hanbali. Rahimahullah ta'ala, one of the Hanbali scholars. He said, وَسُنَنُهُ سِتَّةِ What are the sunnah of Psalm? He said six. And you know, some scholars, they like to mention the number. Why? To prepare your mind. That there are six things I need to know and to memorize. Like the Prophet ﷺ said, Ayatul Munafiq Thalath. So he started by saying the word three. Why? Now your ear, your mind prepared for three things. Ta'jil al-fitr. To make the fitr as soon as possible, to be in a hurry. To break your fast immediately. When you see the sunset, when you hear the Maghrib Adhan, I hear the Mu'addin, Allahu Akbar, khalas, yalla, eat your dates or drink your water. طيب. Should I wait until the Mu'addin finishes the Adhan? No. Some people think that I should wait the Mu'addin. Some people, I don't know from where this concept came, that I should wait until the Mu'addin finishes the Adhan. When the Mu'addin finishes that La ilaha illallah, then I eat and I drink. No, this is wrong. Okay? The Sunnah, when you hear the Mu'addin, the time of Maghrib, Allahu Akbar, or you saw the sunset, you start the iftar. This is Sunnah. Don't say, no, let's wait 2 minutes, 3 minutes. I'm fasting 14 hours. Let's wait for 2 minutes. What's the problem if you wait 2 minutes? The problem that you are opposing the sunnah. The sunnah to break your fast now. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يَزَالُ النَّاسُ بِخَيْرِ مَا عَجَّلُ الْفِطْرِ People are in good state if they are making the iftar quickly. يَلَّا بِسَرْعَة Now don't delay. Don't wait 1 minute, 2 minutes, 15 minutes, or some people wait until they can see the stars. This is not the way of the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. طيب. أيضا عن عبد الميمون said, one of the تابعين, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أسرع الناس إفطارا وأبطأه سحورا. The companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam were. The first people to break the fast and late people of the suhoor meal, the pre-dawn meal. So the sunnah to make your iftar early, your fitr, breakfast, early and your suhoor late. What is the meaning of to make your iftar early? When I hit the adhan maghrib, I eat my dates. Okay, what's the meaning of the suhoor late? It means before the adhan fajr. في صحيح مسلم أبو عطية رضي رحمه الله تعالى he said I went with مسروق مسروق also one of the تابعين to عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها then مسروق said two men from the companions of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كلاهما لا يألو عن الخير both of them intend the good both of them like to do the good they like to follow the sunnah they like to achieve the best. One of them, now who's speaking? Masruq, he's tabi'i. He's telling this to Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Why he wants to confirm with Aisha? Because Aisha, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she knows more about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of them makes the Maghrib and the breakfast makes the it means the maghrib salah and the breakfast of the fast early. يعجل means to make it early as soon as possible. والآخر and the second delays the maghrib, which means the maghrib salah and the iftar, the breakfast. Then she said, who is making this early and or breaking the fast earlier and to pray the maghrib immediately after the sunset? They said Abdullah. Generally when we say Abdullah, it means Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه. There are many Abdullah. Abdullah ibn Zubair, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Ja'far. There are many Abdullah of companions. But mainly when we find Abdullah, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, generally. فقالت هكذا كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصنع. She said, like this the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was doing. What do you notice here? There is something very important. I mean, not related about the siyam, about etiquette, about manners and akhlaq. Yes. She did not say, who is the second one? She said, who is doing this early? Okay. They said, Abdullah. خلاص, this is sunnah. And that's enough. She did not say, who is the second man? No, he's not following the sunnah. You should give him a nasiha and you... So this is very important, brothers and sisters, that what is needed here? Yani, for example, someone came asking you about an issue. Okay, we have two imam. One imam is doing this, one imam is doing that. One imam is praying tarawih 8 rak'ah. The other imam praying 20 rak'ah. Khalas. Which one is correct? Which is one closer to the sunnah? Then I tell you, who's praying 8? You tell me, wallahi, this masjid. Okay, this is the sunnah. For me, no need to ask who's the second one, okay? And also for the question, no need to mention the second one, this that masjid, and he's doing this. Khalas. The point is to know which one is sunnah, which one is not the sunnah, or which is better. So this is a very important point from Aisha, and also from the Tabi'in, Masruq, and the other one, Abu Atiyah, radiyallahu ta'ala, rahimahumullah ta'ala. Okay? So no need, khalas. To open the door of backbiting. طيب. طيب. What is the meaning of السحور? Okay. Because in Arabic language we have تشكيل فتحة ضمة كسرة. So for some words like السحور, الطهور, الوضوء. Okay. You can. يعني there is a word with فتحة and there is a word with ضمة. What do I mean by فتحة? السحور فتحة. الوضوء فتحة الطهور فتحة. Okay. If you put ضمة الطهور السحور الوضوء. What is the difference? If it is فتحة السحور, it means the food. Okay. This is, yeah, for example, if I'm going to eat, this is السحور. My سحور is dates. My سحور. If you put ضمة السحور, it means the action. The action, huh? To do the suhoor, yes. Al-wadu, okay? The water itself. Yeah, for example, I'm going to do the wudu by this bottle. Okay? So this is wadu. This is my wadu. I pour the water. Okay? When I do the wudu, so this is called wudu. Dhamma. So if it is fatha, it is the food or it is the water. If it is dhamma, it is the action. So this is the difference between sahur and suhoor. So he mentioned the sunnah is to make al-iftar early and to delay the suhoor. Okay, what is the meaning? So he said, what's the meaning of sahur and suhoor? What is the meaning to delay the sahur or the suhoor? Okay, to make it very near to the Fajr Adhan. Not after, before the Fajr Adhan. So for example, in this Ramadan, inshallah, what is the time will be? So inshallah, Ramadan will be next week. Wednesday or Thursday in Kuwait will be Wednesday or Thursday. So next week, Thursday will be 23, صح? طيب. So the Fajr Adhan, طيب, 4:30. This is the Fajr Adhan, the second Fajr Adhan. This is to pray Fajr, and the time to stop eating and drinking. So if someone said, "Well, I like to delay the suhoor, to follow the sunnah is to delay the suhoor." Okay, so we tell you, khalas, you do your suhoor maybe 4:25. Sheikh, no time for biryani, for gulab jamun, and these things. Please, brothers, sisters, we need to correct the concept of suhoor. Suhoor doesn't mean to fill your stomach. Suhoor, the concept of suhoor is not to punish your stomach. If you eat one piece of date, this is suhoor, khalas. One sip of water, this is suhoor, enough. Khalas? Agree? I know you don't agree. Mishkila. مشكلة يعني خلاص should be مشبوس لحم مشبوس دجاج تشريب these things ها no ها برأت أول طيب يعني the concept of سحور is to have something before the فجر if you are going to fast tomorrow it should not be a heavy meal طيب it should not be a heavy meal the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said نعم سحور المؤمن what التمر what is a good سحور What is a good sahur for the believing person? Dates. Dates. Alhamdulillah. Eat dates. Drink water. Alhamdulillah. No. If we eat carbs, the carbs will be consumed during 2-3 hours. But if I take lipids, fat, and proteins, this can last for 7 hours. Yalla. When shish tawuk, kebab, and يعني سبحان الله these every year I'm saying it is fasting is not a punishment I have to eat everything before Fajr okay do you know some people يعني it is I don't know this is cheating yourselves or what okay you eat the biryani paratha okay everything you eat kanafa everything okay then before Fajr in 1 minute yeah sunnah you eat one date جزاك الله خير يعني you remember the hadith طيب but it is enough يعني for example you did قيام الليل الحمد لله you finished then you slept you went to sleep from 12 until 4 then you woke up you made your wudu okay maybe you did not pray water you prayed water طيب then before Fajr you eat 2-3-4 pieces of dates الحمد لله you drink water خلاص this is suhoor I know some people feel It is wrong. There is something wrong. I did not take my suhoor. No, you took your suhoor. Alhamdulillah. And Allah will write this for you as sunnah. Alhamdulillah. طيب. Of course, I don't mean if you eat a lot, this is not suhoor. It is suhoor. But I mean if you eat little, also this is suhoor. خلاص? Agree? You agree? You don't agree? This is with your family. I know. طيب. السحور أكلة بركة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه sorry before that. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said تسحروا فإن في السحور بركة. Take the pre-dawn meal because it is بركة blessing. طيب. Another hadith another narration sorry this is Bukhari Muslim. Another hadith in رواه أحمد شيخ الباني said صحيح الجامع السحور or السحور أكلة بركة. السحور this is a بركة meal. بركة فلا تدعوه don't leave it don't miss the سحور ولو أن يجرأ أحدكم جرعة من ماء even if you take sip of water don't leave it don't ignore it طيب فإن الله عز وجل وملائكته يصلون على المتسحرين because Allah سبحانه وتعالى made صلاة on the and his angels on the متسحرين Those who take the suhoor. Okay, so for example, your children, they took the dinner, maybe 11:30 or 12, then they slept because they have school. So, you wake them up before Fajr. Okay, tell them, خلاص, drink water. Drink water. This is good. Why? Because barakah. What kind of barakah? They say, the scholars say, this is the barakah of the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you are following the sunnah. It is a blessing because it will give you the strength to fast. Okay, because if you don't take the suhoor, okay, not for all people, but some people, if they don't take the suhoor, they will be lazy, they like to sleep. Or, you know, some people, I hear that some people, they take the whole month of Ramadan off. Khalas, I cannot work in Ramadan. I wake up in the morning, 9:30, then I come home, 2 or 3 p.m. No, no, no way for that. I cannot. So the whole month of Ramadan, vacation. Okay, maybe 28 days or 20, whatever. So take the meal of suhoor because it is barakah. And also, where is the barakah? The blessing, because this is the opposite. We are opposing Ahlul Kitab. Aklatu sahar. They don't take this meal. And also, the person, subhanAllah, usually those who take the suhoor, they are ready for the salah, fajr. I mean the correct suhoor, not the suhoor 11:30 or 12:30. Because those who take the suhoor 12:30 or 1 a.m., okay, some of them sleep and they miss al-fajr. They take the suhoor, the biryani, kanafa, okay, then maybe, khalas, after the food, khalas, dizzy, okay, what is the time? Okay, you finished your meal 1:30 maybe, and the fajr adhan 4:30, so 3 hours left. This is too much. خلاص. Where is Fajr Salah? مع السلامة. Fajr Salah. So imagine if you take the suhoor, the correct time, يعني 4:15, 4:20, 4:10, طيب. So for sure, inshallah, you will not sleep. You will take your suhoor, then you will go to the masjid to pray. Or if you are when you pray. طيب. And also you will get this salah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى will have his mercy on you when you take the suhoor meal, and also the angels will make dua for you. And also then the author said وَالزِّيَادَ فِي أَعْمَالِ الْخَيْرِ. Okay, sorry, so the suhoor is sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said تَسَحَّرُوا, take the pre-dawn meal. Okay, so this is an order from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but the scholar said this is sunnah, not wajib. It is recommended but not compulsory. It is not compulsory. Okay, why? Because the Prophet ﷺ, in some hadith, he did wisal, which means he did not break his fast. And also some of the companions did that. So it means that it is highly recommended, mustahab, but it is not wajib. So try your best to take the suhoor. And also one of the sunnah, الزيادة في أعمال الخير. Make more, okay, righteous deeds. Salah, sadaqah, Quran, visiting your relatives. Okay, helping the others. This is yani common from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the companions and the scholars and the Salaf after the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. وقوله جهرا إذا شتم. And also this is sunnah to say it جهرا. What does it mean جهرا? Loudly. إذا شتم. When someone insults you, curse you, you say إني صائم. إني صائم. Okay, if someone يعني maybe you are walking, you touch someone by mistake, then he start to shout you, are you blind, are you stupid, crazy, this. Okay, 10-20 words. Okay, attacking you. What is the sunnah? يعني you say sorry, I don't mean anything. Okay, no sorry, and he went angry. خلاص crazy. Say إني صائم إني صائم. You repeat this 2 times. إني صائم إني صائم. طيب. Why? Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said الصيام جنة. صيام is shield. Huh? Say it in Arabic. It is not difficult. Okay. Say it in English. Yes. You say it in your language. Let him understand. Because this depends. Okay. But here, according to his understanding, we should say it in the language that he can understand. Because some scholars said, should we say, the scholars mentioned, should we say it loudly or silent? If the issue is to remind yourself, then you say it loud, silent. You are reminding yourself. But if the issue is to remind him and also to remind yourself, it should be loudly. So this means it should be in a language that he can understand. Okay, but if you don't know his language, خلاص, Google, you show him in his language, Chinese, كيف الدين, whatever the language. طيب, before he hits you. So you say it loudly. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الصيام جنة, fasting is shield, protecting you from the hellfire, protecting you from committing sins. فلا يرفث ولا يجهل. If it is fasting day, خلاص. Don't do rafath, don't do jahal, don't insult, don't curse, don't wrong the people. وإن امرؤ قاتله, if someone is fighting you, أو شاتمه, abusing you or insulting you, فليقل إني صائم two times. إني صائم, إني صائم. طيب, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة, ادفع بالتي هي أحسن. Okay? The hasana is not like sayyah. They are not equal. Hasana, okay, for you. Sayyah against you. They are not the same. Okay? Drinking zamzam water is not like drinking wine. Okay? Praying in the masjid is not like dancing. This is hasana and this is sayyah. They are not the same. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةَ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةَ. And of course, this is like a rule for us. We should be careful. Because, you know, in our societies now, they make them the same, or sometimes they make the sayyi'a, the sin, more better than the hasana. Yani, for example, in Ramadan, alhamdulillah, the Quran competition more. صح? Not only there are Quran competition, but Ramadan more. For the first, 70 KD. The second, 50 KD. The third, 20 KD. طيب? But if there is a competition for singing, maybe the first thousands, خلاص. And sometimes, يعني, they give, يعني, they give nationality because you are a good actor or a good singer. Because of what? You give him nationality because of what? Give the nationality for the one who's memorizing Quran, leading the salah, doing good, explaining Quran, the sunnah, subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةَ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةَ. The hasana sayyah, they are not equal. But people, they are making them equal or sometimes, subhanAllah, يعني higher to the hasana, superior to the hasana. And this is wrong. Quran is not like musiqa, music. And the one who's teaching magic is not like the one who's teaching Quran. ولا تستوي حسنة ولا سيئة, ادفع بالتي أحسن. Try to avoid that. Okay, by doing the best way. So there is a problem. Someone cursing you, insulting you. Okay, so he's doing bad. I should do good by the best way. He's shouting me, you smile. May Allah guide you. Inni sa'im. This is the way of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah mentioned this in the Quran. فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةً كأنه ولي حميم. سبحان الله. This ayah is a very important for us, and especially for those people who say that makfai, they're no use. I tried a lot, but this person cannot be my friend. I'll not speak to him again. This ayah tells you, no. There is a chance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةً. The one who is your enemy, he is your enemy. Okay? If you use this technique, which technique? Which technique? Huh? To reply by the best way, the best word. You choose the best way to reply. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. This enemy will be like not a friend. وَلِي حَمِيمٌ. Okay, يعني a very close friend. Very close, يعني ولي, ناصر, supporter. سبحان الله. And this happened. This happened, يعني. I mean some of the enemies of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, later they became very close friends. Abu Sufyan, Amr ibn al-As, Umar al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu. They were enemies of Islam, fighting the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, trying to kill him. Later, the best friends of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, companions, رضي الله تعالى عنهم. So, don't forget this technique. Don't forget this rule, foundation. Please, we should use this. There is a way. Don't say there is no way. No, there is a way. I tried. Maybe your way was not correct. You did not choose the best way, the best words. صح. Some people, يعني, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was nice with his people, but some of them did not accept Islam. Right? But this can happen. This can happen. And after that, وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. Who can get this level? Very high level. You shout me, you wrong me, and I smile, and I speak good, and I give you gift. People think that I am crazy. But this is very difficult. Not for anyone to reach this level. Subhanallah. وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا. Those who are patient, who can reach this level. وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. Those who have a great يعني part of Islam in their heart and part of Iman in their heart. وقوله جهرا. طيب, they mention, should I say this in any kind of fast, fard or nafl? طيب, he said here, يعني in the sharh, he said in Ramadan, yes, you say it. Someone wronged you, you say inni saim, inni saim, loudly. You tell him like this. But if you are fasting nafl, for example, Thursday, you are fasting Thursday, you are fasting Monday, you are fasting every other day. He said, if you fear that riya can come to your heart, showing off can come to your heart, then say it silently. But inshallah, if you are okay, you say it loudly. You say it loudly, and no problem with that. So this is sunnah. Then he said, وَقَوْلُهُ عِنْدَ فِطْرِهِ. And one of the sunnah to say at the time of iftar, Allahumma laka sumt wa ala rizqika aftart, subhanaka wa bihamdik, Allahumma taqabbal minni, innaka anta as-sami'ul alim, innaka anta as-sami'ul alim. طيب, this hadith not authentic. This hadith not authentic. طيب, the author mentioned this hadith. There is another hadith, ذهب الظمى وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله. This hadith, Sheikh Al-Bai mentioned sahih. Other scholars, they said it is not sahih. But Sheikh Al-Bai said this is sahih. So you can say this dua, inshallah, عند الفطر, when you break your fast. Sheikh Ibn Thaymi said, you don't say this before you eat. طيب, يعني, what we understand from Sheikh Ibn Thaymi, it means that after you drink something. Because what is the meaning of the hadith? ذهب الظمع. The thirst went. طيب, I am thirsty for the whole day, fasting. So now, I took my date. But still I'm thirsty. So if you drink, after drinking the water, a cup of water, two cups of water, you say this dua. Okay, this is the understanding of Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah رحمه الله تعالى. ذهب الظمأ وتلت العوق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله. طيب, if you remember, we discussed the issue, we mentioned the issue that in the dua, it is not allowed to say inshallah. Okay? In your dua, it is not allowed to say inshallah. Allahumma ghfir li warhamni in shi't. Allahumma rzuqni al-jannah in shi't. Okay? It is not allowed to say inshallah in your dua. Here, the hadith says, wa thabata al-ajr inshallah. How? Because in this statement, وَثَبَتَ الْأَجْرِ. So, it is like information. You are confirming that. So, if you are confirming that, so you should add, inshallah. Because I don't know if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me the reward or not. So, I say, وَثَبَتَ الْأَجْرِ. And the reward is confirmed. Am I sure? I'm not sure. So, you should say, inshallah. So, this is not a dua. This statement, not a dua. So that's why they said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned the word inshallah. طيب. And of course the other dua we say, after you finish the food, okay, you say the other dua. And of course, before you eat, you say Bismillah. After you finish, you say Alhamdulillah, الذي أطعمنا. The dua we mentioned about after eating the food. طيب. Here, يعني, if you notice, this dua, يعني, according to Sheikh Ma'thamin said, you say it after you finish your meal or after you drink the water or the drink, laban, water, whatever. What we notice, many people that at the time of Adhan, we hear the Adhan. They start, Allahumma arhamna waghfir lana wa tub alayna ya Rab. They start dua. Okay? This is not sunnah. This is not sunnah. The sunnah, when you hear the Adhan or when you know it, this is the time of Maghrib, yallah. Bismillah, you eat your date. Bismillah, or you drink your water. This is the sunnah. So, subhanAllah, what do you notice? The people who are doing that, they are not breaking their fast. And also, there is another thing. They are not following the Muaddin. The sunnah is to follow also the Muaddin. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu. Tayyib. So, this is not the time. I mean, the sunnah is to break your fast. And they are busy in the dua. Right? Make dua after you finish, you break your fast. Maybe, خلاص, you take one date, Bismillah, you drink water, or only you drink water. Then you say, ذهب الظما تلحق ثبت إن شاء الله. You repeat with the Muaddin, خلاص. But then after that, between the Adhan and Iqam, you make dua. But don't miss the iftar, and you make the dua. And because we mentioned the hadith not authentic. الصائم حين يفطر. The dua is accepted for the fasting person when he breaks his fast. Okay, this is not authentic narration. This is not authentic narration according to Sheikh Al-Bani رحمه الله تعالى. Then he said, وفطره على رطب فإن عدم فتمر فإن عدم فماء. What is the sunnah? To break your fast with رطب. Okay, this is called date. This is date. The one which is a dry date. The one which is, you feel it is like a ball and it is full of water, very soft, this is called rutab. Okay? So the sunnah to start with rutab, the soft date.
Sticky?
Sticky, yes. It says, if you press, you see the liquid.
The one which comes in a huge
bag. Huge?
In the market, the one which is stuck to each other like a.
لا لا لا. This is date. This is date. Yellow. This is in Jam'iyya nowadays. But the rotab, you'll find Jam'iyya, but usually in the freezer or the fridge. The freezer or fridge. And this is like dark brown color. Lighter than, sorry, not dark brown, light brown. Light brown. Okay? And it's very soft. If you press it, you'll see the liquid. We don't have here. Where is Islamic store here? موجود سلمان. طيب. If he comes, Salman, inshallah, will show you from this. If he has rutab, he should provide this. طيب. So you start with rutab. If there is no rutab, tamr, dates. No dates, water. Wajib, this is not compulsory, not wajib, but this is mustahab, this is sunnah. You start with rutab, then or dates or water. Sorry, then, يعني. If this is not available, the second. The third. Soft date. Rotab. Then the date. This is dates. What I have here now, this is dates. This is dates. Okay. Is it clear in the YouTube? They can see? Okay. طيب, you don't have anything now. You can break your fast by the intention. Yes. Maybe you are in a place, maybe you are working a duty. طيب, and there is no water, no day at all. And you will go home maybe after 3 hours. And you cannot leave your place. You are, there is a screen or there is a machine. Okay? Can you break your intention with, can you break your fast with the intention? Yes. You can't break your fast with the intention. Oh, now my intention, I'm breaking my fast. Or if you like, you wait until you go home and you break your fast. طيب. Then he said, يحرم على من لا عذر له الفطر برمضان. It is forbidden the one who doesn't have an excuse to break his fast during the month of Ramadan. يعني not to fast during Ramadan. This is one of the major sins. You are not fasting Ramadan or even one day. Sheikh, I'm fasting 29 days, only one day. I skip one day. No, this is haram, major sin. Not allowed in Islam. طيب. Then the one who doesn't fast one day or more in Ramadan, what should he do? Major scholar said he has to make up this day after Ramadan. So for example, one or two days you missed in Ramadan, we ask why? Sick, traveling? He said, no, but I was at home and I was thinking to cook something and to have a lunch, and I did that. You know this is Ramadan? Yes, I know. Allah Ghafur Rahim. No, this is a major sin. You have to repent. You have to make tawbah. And major scholar said, you have to make up this day after Ramadan. You have to make this day after Ramadan. And the other opinion of Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, and also Shaykh ibn Taymiyyah said, no way to make up this day. Okay? Why? They said, because the ibadah, the siyam is like the salah. It has a start and end. So Ramadan, it has a specific time. Fasting has a specific time, which is the month of Ramadan. So when the month of Ramadan came, you were healthy, okay, and no excuse. So you have to fast. You did not fast, khalas. We tell you, no need to make up this day. What should I do? You have to make istighfar, tawbah. You have to repent. You feel sorry, regret about your major mistake. This is major mistake. And also we ask you to make nawafil. يعني after Ramadan, you fast, for example, every Monday, every Thursday, or every Monday and Thursday, the white days, ayam al-bid. Do a lot of siyam to make compensation. But to make up this day, no way. خلاص. Like the salah. If you miss one salah, no way to make up this day. Yeah, this is the opinion of Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala. Okay, maybe some people say, but Shaykh, we are making it easy for him. We fasted the whole month and he missed 2 days, 3 days. So this is easier for him. No, it is not easier because there is a sin. If he did not repent, then he will be in big trouble. طيب, and also, this is a kind of punishment for him. If you tell him, don't make up this day. But imagine if you tell him, okay, you have to make up this day after Ramadan. What kind of feeling he will have? It's okay, I missed 2 days and they made them up after Ramadan. I missed the salah yesterday and I made up the salah today. خلاص. So he will not have the feeling of the sin. Why? Because already I did that. طيب, I stole something, then I return it back. خلاص. No, this is a major sin. And no way to make up this day. He should feel sorry. He should feel the punishment. طيب. There is a hadith. من أبطل يوما من رمضان من غير رخصة ولا مرض لم يقضي عنه صوم الدهر كله وإن صامه. The one who breaks a day in Ramadan, break his fast in Ramadan without an excuse, without sickness, he cannot make up this day even if he fasts the whole year. He will not make up this day. But this is not authentic hadith. This is not authentic hadith. طيب. So sometimes people ask, many times people ask, Sheikh, I missed many Ramadan. Or not maybe the whole Ramadan. Okay? Yani subhanallah, for some people, okay, Allah alam, many people or few people, but for some people they at the age of puberty. Okay, khalas, he or she, 14 years old, 15 years old, they are adults. But they were in the school. So, and maybe they are in a non-Muslim country. Or maybe they are in a Muslim country, but in the school, many people don't fast. Wallahi, mushkila nowadays. Yani, subhanAllah, we hear now. I will not say common, but it is there. The students in the school don't fast. They don't fast. Habibi, you are 14 years old, 15, 16. Why you are not fasting? Not fasting. So for at the age of, okay, if he's adult from the age of 14, then 15, 16, then at the age of 30, okay, he comes and he asks, Sheikh, at the beginning of my puberty, I did not fast. Or I was fasting some days. Okay? So according to the majority scholars, they say, you have to make up these days. But according to the second opinion, Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, no way to make up these days. You have to make istighfar, tawbah, repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And please, brothers and sisters, make sure that your children fasting Ramadan with us. I mean those who are adults. This is wajib, compulsory. You have to make sure they are fasting until the others. Many times people ignore. No, still they are students. Okay, if they are students, said, so what? Khalas, he is an adult. Mukallaf, the angels writing. Khalas, now they are writing everything, good or bad. It is serious. The salah. Tayyib. If the person believes it, this is not compulsory, then he is kafir, he is not Muslim. We tell him, this is five pillars in Islam. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu Muhammad Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Iqam as-salah, ita'a az-zakah, sawm Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, shah Ramadan, fama shahida minkum shah falaysum. And you mentioned for him the proofs from Quran and Sunnah, then he said, no, it is not compulsory, this is not Muslim. This is not Muslim. Okay, we have to believe this is part of Islam, with this one of the pillars of Islam, fard. We are not talking about new Muslim. Maybe there is a new Muslim. Still, he is learning. Okay, we teach him. But after making the things clear for him, and he insists this is not wajib, this is kafir, not Muslim. Sorry? Inshallah, we'll come to this pregnancy. Then he said, ويجب الفطر. It is compulsory to break the fast, not to fast. على الحائض والنفساء. The women during the menstrual period and the postpartum bleeding after giving birth. It is not allowed to fast. الحديث أليس إذا حاضت لم تصلي ولم تصم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned that. If she is ha'ad, she doesn't pray and she doesn't fast. And also, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala said, كَانُ يُصِيبُنَا ذَلِكَ فَنُؤْمَرْ بِقَضَاءِ الصَّوْمِ وَلَا نُؤْمَرْ بِقَضَاءِ الصَّلَاةِ. Yeah, this was coming to us. She means the period. And we were ordered to make up the fast and not the salah, which means they were not fasting. They were not fasting the month of Ramadan during the period. My daughter, she in the exam today, I think today, yes. She was upset. Why? Because the exam about Siyam. Maybe you can put this question in the exam. Okay. The first exam, about 60 people. The second exam, maybe 27 people. Where are the others? Okay, not interested in doing the exam? Very easy exam. After the class, go and do the exam. The first and second, yalla. So the question was, one of the things that break the fast, yeah, put three or four. So my daughter, she put al-ha'ad, one, al-nufasa, two. So the teacher said, no, wrong, this is only one answer. My daughter said, but they are two, they are different, ha'ad, nufasa, different. So what do you think? Who's correct, my daughter or the teacher? Who are supposed not to fast? And the question to list three or four. So my daughter put number one, ha'ad, the woman during the period. Number two, an-nufasa, the woman in the postpartum bleeding. So the teacher said, no, I'll put you only one mark. Huh? شوف the scholars, I told my daughter what is written in the book. In the book they wrote them as one. حقل النفساء. يعني usually the scholars they say حقل النفساء together. So we assume them as one. So one mark. طيب. Yes, they are different. The حقل is not like نفساء. طيب. But in the exam, يعني in the books, the scholars they say they are one. Yeah, I mean they don't mean the same, but one answer. يعني. In our exam. طيب. وعلى من يحتاجه لإنقاذ معصوم من مهلكة. And also, it is compulsory to break your fast. If there is someone needs the help, sorry, not if there is someone, he said ma'soom. What does he mean ma'soom? The one whose life is, not in danger. يعني it is haram to spill his blood, haram to kill him. Okay, يعني. I'm not saying innocent, you know, like it is not allowed to kill the Muslim. It is not allowed to kill the non-Muslim who lives in the Muslim country with the contract. Okay? So this is called ma'soom al-dam. But if there is يعني a war between two countries, okay, then someone from the other country, a non-Muslim country, he came inside the country. He tried to يعني to enter like a spy. He's our enemy. So, is it allowed to kill him? Yes, he's our enemy. There is a fight between us and he entered the country without permission. So his blood is not saved. His soul is not saved in Islam. طيب, if you see this person, okay, يعني in a fire, I know this is a spy, then he is in a car and there is fire in the car. So, and I am a firefighter, but if I try there to subside the fire, then I need to break my fast. Okay? No, we tell you, this is not allowed. Let him die. Why? Because we're supposed to kill him. He's a spy coming from enemy. So this is the meaning of ma'soom dam. So if there is, يعني, those who are working in Matafi, the firefighters, if there is, may Allah protect us, there is a fire in a building. So for sure, if they enter, they will sweat a lot. Okay, should they save the people who are inside the building? Yes. Muslim or non-Muslim, yes, they have to save them. Okay, do I need to break my fast? Okay, yes, you need, then you have to break. You have to drink the water and you enter. Or maybe after you finish, you need to drink water. Then you have. Why? To save yourself. Okay, so saving yourself also related to save the others. So this is the meaning of you need to break your fast to save someone. طيب. Then he said, وَيُسَنُّ لِمُسَافِرٍ يُبَاحُ لَهُ الْقَصْرُ وَلِمَرِيضٍ يَخَافُ الضَّرَرُ. And it is allowed. Okay, the previous point, it is compulsory. But here he said, and this is allowed. And this is sunnah. وَيُسَنُّ. It is sunnah for the traveler to break his fast. So here in the Hanbali madhab in Dalil al-Talib, he said, this is sunnah for the traveler. Okay? لِمُسَافِرْ يُبَاحُ لَهُ الْقَصْرِ. For the traveler who is allowed to make qasr in the salah. Okay? Because you know, different types of safar, traveling, this is allowed to make qasr, not allowed. So he said, if it is allowed to make qasr, then it is sunnah not to fast. It is sunnah not to fast. When you come to this issue, you'll find many opinions about that. And you'll find also different, several hadith. You'll find the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not fasting. You find the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fasting. And the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praising those who were not fasting. Okay? So you'll find different ahadith. So always I'm saying when we talk about this issue, don't take one hadith because you know some people say, khalas, khalas, khalas. Don't fast because the Prophet ﷺ said, Inna Allah yuhib an tu'ta rukhsa. Allah likes to follow the easy way, to follow the excuse. خلاص. This is wrong way. To take only one hadith, then you build the ruling on this hadith. What about the other hadith? Why ignore all the hadith? And you follow one hadith? No, you have to gather all the hadith. So you'll find the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was fasting. Another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling people don't fast. Another hadith, you find only the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abdullah ibn Rawah were fasting. Sheikh Uthaymeen said, "Yani like the summary. What is the conclusion from all the hadith?" He said, "If it is easy for you to fast while traveling, then we tell you it is better for you to fast. It is easy. Then we tell you, خلاص, you fast. Don't delay your Ramadan, the days of Ramadan after Eid. خلاص, you fast with people. Why? Because it is easy. Wajib, it is compulsory, not compulsory, but it's better for you, sunnah for you to fast. طيب. The second way. If it is difficult for you to fast, or if there is a kind of difficulty to fast, then we tell you it's better not to fast. The third, if it is dangerous to fast, how? يعني you are traveling for jihad, and you are going to fight the enemy. Did you? No, don't fast. This is dangerous. You fast, then you are lazy and you are sleepy. No, no, no. You have to take the food to be ready for fighting. So this is the case where it is haram to fast. طيب. So yeah, like what is the example when we say it is easy? يعني, suppose you are working in a company and you are working from 8 to 4 every day in Ramadan. Every day in Ramadan you are 8 to 4. So you wake up 7 morning, okay, drop your children, you go to work. Meeting here, speaking, giving lecture, okay, checking something, or maybe if you are a teacher, okay, and you are going around, you are teaching kids here and there, yani, especially for the sisters, jumping here, there, okay. So, and they finish maybe 3 or 4. They come home, and if she's a woman, cooking, no sleep, خلاص. Then iftar, then isha, taraweeh. So خلاص, she's very tired. طيب. Then they want to go to Umrah. So she took off 3 days. So Thursday is off. And the flight, 5 p.m. for example. 5 p.m. Or let's say 4 p.m. So Thursday off. She prayed the Fajr, then she slept. Okay, she woke up. Okay, 3 p.m. she prayed Dhuhr. Then after 20 minutes she prayed Al-Asr, she went to the airport. Okay, which day is easier or difficult? The working day or the traveling day? I mean, يعني she went to the airport and the flight was 5 p.m. and Maghrib Adhan 6. Okay, which is easier? The working day or the traveling day? The traveling day, much easier. She's happy, no headache from the kids, no cooking, alhamdulillah. So, yeah, I mean, I've given you this example to imagine, yeah, and how the traveling day will be easier than the normal, or it is easy. So if you feel it is normal, easy, no change, خلاص, you fast, it's better to fast. But if there is some kind of difficulty, yeah, alhamdulillah, nowadays you can't drive, صح? So you decide to drive after Fajr. So you pray the Fajr Masjid, yalla. Your wife, your children, yalla, we are ready. You start your car, yalla, bismillah. You went to Salmi. Then Salmi, yalla. You wait maybe 4 hours. And you are going from this cabin to this employee here, there. Then after you finish, there was problem in the car, you stopped to fix the car. So there was kind of difficulty, you are sweating. Can you fast? Yes, you can fast. But there is kind of difficulty. So we tell you, it's better to break the fast. Don't fast. It's better for you not to fast. Why? Because there is a kind of difficulty. Not impossible, but there is a kind of difficulty. Right? So if it is easy, you fast. If there is some kind of difficulty, don't fast. And also what is important, the Prophet, the companion said in one hadith, we were traveling and some of us fasting, some of us not fasting. Those who were fasting were not blaming the other group. And this group were not blaming the fasting group. So please, when you travel together, some of you fasting, some of you not fasting, so don't blame the other group. Khalas. Ah, why are you not fasting? The whole of this muscle and you are strong, you are not fasting, shinoada. Are you a kid? Are you? No need. And if there is a thin person, maybe your wife, why you are fasting? Okay? You are thin and you are anemic, you are khalas, let her to fast. She likes to fast, let her to fast. Okay? So don't blame either side. Maybe. Stop, inshallah. Dinner ready? Okay. We stop here. Jazakumullah khair. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.